It is not a matter of Gujarat and Himachal alone. It cuts at the root of several fundamental constitutional principles. Firstly, it is the grossest interference with a constitutional body, the Election Commission of India, which has earned much respect globally. It is a direct interference by this government in a shamefaced, shameless manner. Second, it violates something which the Supreme Court has repeatedly called the basic structure of the Indian Constitution, because free, fair, and unbiased elections have been held to be part of our democracy, and democracy with free, fair, unbiased elections has been held to be part of our basic structure. That is, as far back as 1975, in a popularly titled judgment called Indira Nehru Gandhi versus Raj Narayan, a constitution bench. Thirdly, it is a fundamental assault on a level playing field concept. The heart and soul of a fair election, and therefore of a vibrant democracy, is a level playing field. Fourthly, facts tell you that the BJP, firstly, is trying to convert an election commission into an election omission. And that's not my phrase, my copyright. It's what you have, in fact, already noted. A drowning man is desperately clutching at the straw of a constitutional unit called the Election Commission. Doopti naav ko chunav aayog ke tinke ke sahare, ye sarkar aur party sattarur bachana chahti hai. We have the figures here which show that except for 2002 and 3, when the riots disrupted all normal governance, and the riots have their own story against the present Prime Minister and several BJP leaders. Except for that 1 year, these two Himachal and Gujarat elections have been always held in tandem. It has been so in 98, so in 2007, so in 2012, and would have been and should have been so in 2017. Thirdly, friends, a series of falsehoods, excuses, clear attempts to fool you and treat you like children who eat grass as if not responsible citizens are being trotted out minute by minute, day by day. And they are so laughable. They would be laughable if they were not tragic for this country. One excuse is that we have to have polls, namely the model code of conduct should not exceed 45, 46 days. Now, are you being told that in 98, for Gujarat and for Himachal, this 45 days was 67 days? 2002, 2003, which we are not counting, was also 49 days for Gujarat, 50 days for Himachal. 2007, 74 days for Gujarat, 79 days for Himachal. 2012, 79 days for both Gujarat and for Himachal. What happened to this great 45 days mandatory, unalterable, written in stone limit? I don't know. Reminds me of that English saying, show me the face, I will show you the rule. The rule will change according to the face changing. Another nice excuse is trotted out. There are innumerable states, friends, in the last 15, 20 years, where this 45-day rule, which is now trotted out both by the Election Commission and by the Government of India and by Mr. Modi's ruling party, has been never observed. It was not observed in Delhi elections, in Mizoram elections, in Rajasthan elections, Maharashtra elections, Arunachal elections, Andhra Pradesh elections. Then, friends, if Himachal Pradesh residents are also citizens of India, did the government think for a moment that they will poll and vote on 9th of November, but must wait till an unknown, undisclosed date till middle of December or even later to get their results, just to please Modi ji and the ruling BJP? Are Himachalis not citizens of India, or are they second-class citizens of India, that to satisfy the whim and caprice, the arbitrariness of this ruling party and this government, they must wait endlessly from 9th November to an undisclosed date in the middle or the end of December? Then, friends, Yet another reason is pointed out. Floods in Gujarat. Of course, they assume that your memories are not existing, or that everybody is a fool because floods in Gujarat happened in July 2017. And if you could not cure floods in Gujarat from July 2017 to October 2017, then which magical wand are you going to cure it by the end of October or early November 2017? Surely the Gujarat election will be announced by November early 2017. By a magic wand with Mr. Shah or Mr. Modi, in next 15 days the floods problem will be cured. Friends, we have heard at least 89 sermons from the Honorable Prime Minister and an equal number from all his major functionaries about the vital importance of simultaneous elections in this country, without telling you how no confidence motions, how 23 states and such a big country will have simultaneous elections without massive constitutional amendment and with no all-party consensus. But we have had sermon after sermon for the last 3 years, his favorite topic. So much about simultaneous elections requiring such a huge constitutional amendment, and you don't want to have simultaneous elections in Himachal and Gujarat, which you've been having in every election since 1998 except 2002-2003. Is this sincerity? Is this honesty? Is this truth? If you want to be Santa Claus, and Santa Claus is a very revered, saintly person who does good, fake Santa Clauses who break the hearts of children are not good people. Fake Santa Clauses who cheat people are not considered good in any theme. If Mr. Modi and his government wants to be a series of fake Santa Clauses going across Gujarat, well then why should the people of India suffer? And why should they not stand exposed through you? Why do I call them Santa Claus? Friend, this is very serious. This is, I would call, actually, if there is a concept of collective bribery, this is an attempt at collective bribery. On Thursday, obviously in tandem with the deferred and delayed dates of election, Thursday was yesterday, friends, 12th of October, a series of SOPs are announced in respect of Patidar community, in respect of Valmiki community, in respect of lakhs of government servants. And most interestingly, the Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation, about an hour or 2 hours before the Election Commission, strange announcement of Himachal now, Gujarat will announce later. About a couple of hours before that, clears proposals of 530 crores in less than 10 minutes. This is bribery. This is collective bribery, or at least attempted bribery. And here we have our Honorable Prime Minister telling you so much about morality, about swachhta of thought, deed and action, as if everybody in the BJP was like the three statues of Gandhiji, who saw no evil, did no evil, heard no evil. Friends, this is something which intersects on morality, on ethics, on law, on constitutional law, on basic structure of the Indian Constitution, on level playing field, on the very foundations of our democracy, and for short-term cheap political gain should never ever been, have been attempted by this government. After all, we have also won many elections, we have lost some elections. The BJP may be in power today, somebody else will be in power tomorrow, but this is not the way to erode and assault and ultimately eliminate the foundations of our constitutional principles, which is precisely what makes us different from each of our South Asian neighbors. Each of our South Asian neighbors reflect the wrecks and ruins of constitutionalism. We are a proud, shining exception. And it is that proud, shining exception which Mr. Modi and his team are flagrantly and shamelessly demolishing.